Ivorian refugees in Ghana, who have been in the country since the year 2011 after the election violence in the country, are asking for more support to improve their well-being. Now, although their lives have largely improved since the arrival in 2011, the Ivorians at the Ampem refugee camp in the Western region have employment and security challenges that they have been raising. Our correspondent, Akwesi Ejenim, has more.
In 2011, that the Ivorian electionary confusion actually brought about the refugee situation here at the Ampem refugee camp, these were the structures that they were actually living in. 8 years after they are coming in here, these are the structures that most of them are currently occupying. But residents over here who are refugees are still not satisfied with the state of the structures that they are living in.
We are grateful to Ghana, yes, and to Ghanaians for receiving us here. But 8 years in a refugee camp is not easy. So we are facing so many challenges. You can see the quality of the shelter that you have here. You see the quality of the sand, the quality of the cement. This shelter, maybe we fall 2 days and 2 years coming. Also, you have challenges when it comes to school. Most of our children, as I was explaining, they stop to go to school because when we came here, we were doing French, and now you have to do English. So they have to send them back. Those who are in SHS, they have to send them to primary school, you see, for them to go and learn English before they will be able to continue. So some of them stop to go to school. And for the parent, there is no job. So how are we going to support our children or our brothers? So these are some of the challenges we are facing here.
On education, the over 3,000 Ivorian refugees at the Ampem camp are entitled to the free SHS, but that is not enough for those who want higher education.
I came here in 2011. I was 11 years old with my mom and my little brother, and we've lived here. I mean, the situation is really harsh, but you try and do your best and try to cohabitate with the people around, learn the language. I'm trying to move on. It's not easy, but what can we do? Well, I wrote the WASI last year, and like they said here, we are still waiting for scholarships and all that. This year, though, they gave the opportunity to people who were not able to pass in core subjects to retake it, which I find it good. So we need support, because going to school and competing with people are having all their resources, textbook and all that, whilst you have nothing. You don't even have the transportation sometimes to go back to. It's quite difficult. So.
In the last 8.5 years, the Ampem refugee camp in the Lembe district of the Western region has been in existence. The camp has just not grown from temporary structures to permanent ones, which includes fire and health posts, as well as police station. But the growing numbers has also increased employment and security concerns, according to the Ivorian leader at the camp.
Ghana itself as country is not able to employ its inhabitants. So it's difficult for refugees we are to get a proper, to get a job in Ghana. That is why we are pleading with the government to have a look on us, our situation, so that they can help us. They can help us maybe in resettlement in the entire country, because we know Ghana has done a lot for us. Yes, they are still doing a lot, but they cannot solve all our problems. So we are pleading with the government of Ghana. We are pleading with the president, His Excellency Nana Addo. We are pleading with him to advocate on our behalf. To the country in need of refugees, for them to come and support us. If possible, why not? If possible, to resettle, to grant us resettlement.
The Western Regional Representative of the UNHCR, Charles York, responded to some of the concerns raised by the Ivorian refugees.
Because their children are their future, and they want their children to go to the tertiary institutions and then be able to become somebody better in future. Now, they don't have money to pay the school fees, even when the government has waived the foreign fee application to the refugees. Refugees are to pay like normal Ghanaians, but they are unable to pay the normal Ghanaian fee that they have to pay. We have a German government has given some scholarship to refugees, but the numbers, if you look at the number of people who pass for the tertiary institutions, and then you look at the available places for the scholarship, it's so, the gap is wide. So that's what the refugees are appealing, that if partners can help to bridge the gap, the German government is doing well, but there may be other governments can also help, other embassies who have some scholarship schemes can come on board and help expand the opportunities for their children to access tertiary education.
For City News, I am Akwesi Ejenim, Ampin Refugee Camp.